Hello one and all, and welcome back to some more Code Vein. My voice may start to be faltering, but we're gonna go anyway. Pretty sure I'm gonna lose it by tomorrow or today at some point. Or it's stuck like this, I'm not sure which. But we're gonna find out. So, I've completed adepts in the meantime. I think that means we now have unlocked the last scout, hopefully. What is it? Still vestige? Scout 2. Yes. And I think this might be the last vestige we restore in the series. This is more to go. There is a DLC, but I'm not whether I'll play it straight afterwards or not. I don't know. It depends on after I fight the final boss. If we end up killing the boss and then we load back into the area.
Our investigation led us to a revenant settlement. What we discovered there was far worse than some missing blood beads. Instead, we found humans being used as livestock.
Okay.
And among them was a woman I recognized.
Oh.
Her name was Jessica. She was the missing fiance Davis had been searching for all this time.
Oh dear. So we'll continue because it was, I can say. So yeah, if the game ends up saying, okay, you can stay in this NG until you decide to proceed onwards, and then I'll stay in this and probably do the DLC. If not, I guess the series will end until I get to that point in the next Gen Plus, my own playthrough, until I can continue it. But I can't guarantee when that'll be. That could be within a week or within a year from now. So, I don't know. It's no guarantee. Rescues were sent to a government shelter. Those were the rules, and there were no
exceptions. I checked around until I found a good facility, then put in a request that she be placed there. Maybe not the best life.
Maybe the camera.
At least she wouldn't be tormented by revenants
anymore. That's true.
She said she was looking for her fiancé, a man named Tyrone. But I was unable to help her. No, that's not it. I made a choice not to help her. I felt that if I did, the man I knew as Davis would disappear.
Oh, why? Why? Why did you take him away from his fiance? I mean, I understand why.
I even tried to do it on more than one occasion.
And you lived him too much. Still, dick move.
What he'd do if he knew she was still alive. I couldn't bring myself to do it. The words just got stuck in my throat. Please forgive me, Davis. I know that I'm a coward. But you see, I love you.
Aw. Still, dick move, but aw. So what Davis has got to say about this?
Given up. I thought those memories were truly gone forever. Naomi, I'm so sorry. I was hurting you all that time, and I never even realized it.
You kind of get a little bit angry,
mate.
Thank you
so much for helping Jessica. It's impossible to express just how grateful I am.
But again, he had to give up, I guess. I don't know, I think he should. I should have a question. I think I should actually ask. Just
no,
tell him.
It's better this way.
No, I think you should, mate.
Even if I had found her again, I didn't want to approach her. Revenants and humans cannot live together. As long as she's safe now, that's enough for me. I'll keep living my life as Davis. I'll hold on to the memory of Naomi, who loved me. And from the shadows, I'll work to keep Jessica safe. You have my deepest thanks. Because of you, my life has hope again.
That's a kind of a cramped reality, to be honest, though, if the Revenants and the humans can't coexist. Because that means we're just going to end up being soldiers as Revenants for the entirety of the rest of time. If you don't die or frenzy, that is. Well, just if you don't die, you just come back. If you don't frenzy, you know, so that's it. You become a soldier the rest of your life. You're frenzy. That's a choice of the Revenants. You know, that's what they now are. Or now are. My voice sounds freaking awful. I don't know how long you'll put up with this voice for, but we'll find out. Anyway, I guess it's time. That's the one. Well, I don't want to go back just yet. Can I proc anything else, maybe?
I know what I have to do. I'll watch your back.
Let me know. That all sounds familiar to me.
That bastard meat with the red meat.
Okay, I don't think we can proc anything else. Upgrade. Can we upgrade?
Make sure you.
Actually, if I can't, I got 1+10 already. That's also 1+10. Wait, wasn't there a scout code? Do I have that already? Oh, I do. Oh yeah, I've been using the max out proficiency when I can, but I ran out again. Hang on, if I change to that, would that... Have you even looked at that yet? That code properly? So look, stat-wise. I don't really get anything. I mean, I go to the mobility quick category. Oh wait, no, that's on weapon 2. Or also that's all. Never mind. Base mobility is quick. Okay, it's on the left I should be looking at. Normal there. Lose quite a lot of stats, to be honest. Actually, not a lot. Not in defense. Defense, I lose what, -1 on most things. So that's not too bad. Weapon attack 1 goes down quite a bit. Weapon 2, actually, I lose in everything. Why am I losing so much? Wait, hold on. Let me equip it. Let's put all my stuff on it. I would have normally. So, Halberd Mastery. What else do I use? Health boost increases maximum HP. Wait. Ooh. Can I switch the spot? Hang on. There we go. Oh, wow. That's pretty good, actually. That kind of sucks. Yeah, I should probably stop messing with that. Let's go to. Person, there we go. What would I use? Wait, hang on. What did I use on if one? Okay. So that one. Was it that one? I think it was that one. And no, this one. I think. Let me just see if that's correct. Diamond, square, and then arrow and diamond. Yeah. And then these, I remember. That is. What's that? Dodge attacks by transforming to mist. I'll have a look at that in a second. No. Down with Chariot Rush. I want my stagger as well. I like my stagger. Where's my stagger? Was up here? No, that'll be there. And then hammer buffs, so Bridge to Glory. And I know, don't think I should bother with the other buff actually. I just tend to lose it. I'm not good at not getting hit. I'm always getting hit. Temporary increase gift speed for you and your partner. Interesting. They're worth having on, I don't know. Haston uses power to icon with reflexes. Oh, I don't know what I want. What's that one? No. Cause this is the main stuff I'll be using, is this 4 up here. I'm gonna need the restore item thing. Normal offering will do. What do I usually have down here? Oh, I try sort of clash related stuff and then the extra buff, which I'm not going to use. So what does this one come with again? Stun buff, augmented regeneration, slow trap, blood barrage. I guess I could do almost entirely, I apologize. I guess adrenaline. We'll put that buff there anyway. In case I don't get hit, I guess. That could be good if I was using a heavy weapon. We've got any dodging enhancing ones, actually. So I don't get hit. Let's have a quick look what we got. Use the power of Ike will temporarily boost reflexes and enhancing your dodges. And I think that'll be it for. Oh, wait, it's one here. Can't temporarily reduce stamina. The effect ends when you take damage. Ah! No, I don't have the damage ones. Because I'm going to get hit. Even though the purpose of me doing this is so I don't get hit, but I still don't trust myself that much. Certainly increases strength and dexterity. Yes, more damage. There we go. I'm not sure if this is worth using at the still point. It still was fine out. So, that the Queen Slayer. Oh, wow. Okay. This is still the better one to use. But not by much. I mean, defense is sorted. I'm only losing a little bit on weapon one. I've actually brought that up really freaking well, to be honest. Lose a bit of health. Icor's higher. Ability's quick. Lose a strength stat. Drain attack goes down slightly. I've got a feeling I could probably make a few of these classes really good. Because at the moment I'm just kind of using this, mainly because, well, how do I, this ability, Final Journey is too good, and that's quite good as well. These are nice little situational ones to use, but this is just default. I do like the staggering one. I think the staggering one, precision, is my favourite, so far. That could change. Is it worth levelling up? So look, what I get to tell you, I want another 10 levels. Yeah, let's do it. I know I say I don't want to level up because I don't want to affect my skill leveling, but screw it. Let's go kill this thing. We're gonna go take him down. Oh, I got to fight his first form again. Woo! I wasn't sure what would happen if I quit. If I had to fight it or not. Let's find out. Why not? Clearly I don't have to fight it again, what am I about? Mia, don't you start again. Right, I'm gonna boost up now. Didn't mean to click that one. Oh well, clicked it now. It's got two phases, I need to remember that. And back in we go. That was a complete failure. Right, I'm actually gonna pot now. I hate the fact he goes to, maybe I should stop using that. Wait, she still died? You know I used it? Hey, Rick, give me back my I-Core.
Oh, you're back.
I don't feel like I'm the right level for this. I feel like I still need to level up more. At the same time, I can't really farm to level my abilities if I do anymore, so it's kind of like, well, what do I do?
Thanks.
Alright, I'm gonna sprint past him. Oh, I hate that shot. Oh, I could target parts of his body. Did I always know that? Okay, if I lagged there, or I didn't hit at all. No, I didn't hit at all. Mia, don't you die. I need sleep. I need the distraction. And the health. There we go. Please stop missing. I actually think that's killing me. That's not what I wanted to do. Stop changing the selection. No. Healer, 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 healer. Oh, for Christ's sakes.
Okay.
faction agreed at the last minute. But again, there's a second phase I want to slide anyway, so forget it.
Hey, are you okay?
You? You have to roll, you have to dodge. You should probably start doing it. You might survive a bit longer than you. But again, I don't want to freaking talk. But again, I think the auto-talk will screw me up more than anything else. And my bad timing of using buffs. Is there a way? Oh yeah, there's an ability for buffing speed, wasn't there? Oh, gift speed, whatever it was. Mia. Mia, please, 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 just don't let me die. Will you stop focusing me? Mia exists! Bloody hell! Oh no. Oh no, don't stop! Ability spout, I hate bosses that do that. There's no time to even move. Oh, come on! You missed me! Can't even see what's going on. He's too big. I will admit, this is probably my least favorite boss in the entire game, just because it's hard to see what's going on. There's too much on the screen. Mainly the boss's fat ass, but you know. Target Mia! Why do you switch to me every time I buff? Attack, here we go. Okay, under room's not safe, I thought it was, never mind. Stop ability spamming, for Christ's sake. Just come down and land. Come on, I need you to die. Not you, Mia, you stay alive. Oh, come on, you didn't even touch me. Bloody hitboxes. Alright, that one you got me. Stop! There we go. Ah, finally. Wait. Hold on, that was second phase, right?
We don't have a lot of time.
Was there a second phase?
Hey, kid, can you handle this?
Okay. I thought there was a second phase. I'm kind of confused what it's not now. I remember there being a second phase. Did we get to second phase and it stayed as a second phase? Did it not reset? I should be caring what's happening on screen. I'm just trying to get my brain to work right now. I reckon it went in the second phase and then it didn't reset when we died. I thought they'd never have they really, so that's probably what happened.
That Silver once held.
Yes.
The powers that you have inherited from them are now, by your will, bound to your flesh. And Vayne sleeps again, for what might be called forever. Thirst creates dread. Revenants desperately fight ever larger numbers of the lost for what few blood beads they can find. But for now, please, rest peacefully. Until the time of your awakening comes once again.
That's why I took Silver's place. Okay. So why is Io turning to stone? Am I also turning to stone? Because Io can't really be an attendant if she's a statue.
Don't worry. I will always be with you.
Yeah, but why are you turning to stone? I thought they only passed away or went frenzied or, you know, something happened to them. If something happened to the successors they were attending. So why is she turning to stone? I'm asleep, right? I ain't dead. If I was dead, I would have dispersed. I don't know how I feel. Okay, so the reason I'm saying that is because of the final boss. The final boss, it wasn't a fun boss. It was a sponge. It wasn't a fun boss to fight. It was a sponge. Its moves were annoying. The auto attack hitting it was annoying. You know, if I could hit it fairly, you know, and I was not missing attacks and just wasting stamina for no reason because of how tall he is, it probably would have been a more fun fight. I think it's just the fact my kinetics couldn't connect. I had to go for his legs each time. But because you're not using the auto attack, you're not dodging his attacks, you're just dodging in a random direction. If that makes sense. So I think that kind of took the fun out of it a bit. also, I don't know if the reason I like using the auto target, because it also focuses on the person you're fighting, which is great. I prefer that. It doesn't need to auto target. If it just auto focused itself, I'd have to do that, you know, because it puts the enemy in the middle of the fight. It's easier. It's, well, I would say it's easier that way. I say it's more fun that way. But about the entirety of the game, I enjoyed this game. I didn't want it to end. I really like this game. I mean, replayability wise, I'd probably still play Dark Souls 1. Out of all the Souls like games I've played, I think that's still the one I'd always go back to and play over and over again. But I could definitely see myself doing a few new game plus runs on this. But this is copyrighted music, isn't it? Oh god, no. Oh dear. I will have to do some editing with this, I think. Up the pitch of quite a bit, or lower it quite a bit. Change the tempo, I don't know, speed up a little bit. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I have to do something. I enjoyed the game. The game was fantastic. I didn't want it to end, I wanted to keep going a bit. That said, there were a couple of bosses in it that I found more annoying than fun. But I do think it's hard for to make a boss for players to fight. That's supposed to be hard and fun at the same time. I don't mind drawn out fights, as long as I'm not being hit by abilities that I would say are bollocks, like scattershotting the entire map and stuff like that. I don't like abilities like that because it is bollocks. I like fair abilities where it's fair to dodge. Also, the hitbox, better than Dark Souls' hitboxes. I can't say it's not. The Dark Souls hitboxes were atrocious. The sword could be swinging in the opposite direction to where you are standing and you'd still take damage. In this, you have to be somewhere around the blade, I guess, to take damage. Or the weapon. Music was great. Characters I liked. But again, I will say this again, if there's going to be a code vein too, please put more expression on the characters' faces. It's all I want for the characters right now. They were just blank slates of music moving mouths. That's all I felt. Actually, did the mouth even move? I'm not even sure at this point in time. I thought it was just faces. Just that. Imagine if I stood here now. Imagine if his face just sat doing nothing. But then I dubbed this video to make myself say something. You know, it just doesn't feel right. I recommend this game. I really do. Anyone who hasn't played it, I would say play it. I arrived late to this game as I first started. The DLCs were already out, so I would say play the game. Good game. I can barely hear myself talk or think of this music being so loud. But I'm not complaining because it's pretty good. Oh, this was in English, okay. I'm not sure what the first one was in English or not, to be honest. I just blanked out. Got to try to talk. I've got to do the same to this one as well now. I can't do it. The music's so loud, my brain is. Right, I'm gonna take it. I am going to take one of the headphones off so I can talk. I recommend this game. This game is brilliant. It's fantastic. It was fun. Definitely enjoyed it. As I said, some of the bosses weren't fun to fight. They were more on the annoying side. But then again, every game's got that. I can't say this game solely has that. kind of wish it was a bit longer. Maybe a bit more optional stuff to do, or extra areas to go and explore that weren't part of the main game. The game was very linear. Kind of wish the skills were a bit easier to obtain. I think they were to start off with quite fair and easy to obtain, but after a while they just became a pain to do it. I think the scaling was a bit too harsh on the ability levels. Especially if you weren't planning to use them, you were just trying to level up for the sake of leveling up. So maybe the abilities should have like a tier system, and depending on what tier they are, depends on how hard they scale with level. Maybe that should be a thing. I don't know, because it wasn't. I did find it very annoying to level up most of the skills, because I'd just be farming death bosses just as I'm leveling up. Because it's the only way I could see doing it efficiently. And it wasn't fun, because you got fed up fighting the bosses after a while. But I will say this, I've been putting off playing this game for a very long time now. Because I knew it was going to an end, and I didn't want it to end. I was having so much fun with the game, and I knew it came to the end, and I didn't want it to end. But here it is, it's finished now. For now, at least, it's finished. I'm not sure about the DLCs, as I said earlier, whether I'll come back later on or I won't come back to them. It depends on what happens after the credits finish. Might end up in my same world, my progress counts, I'll look around for any more optional stuff I can pick up when the game's completed, or if there's any extra things I can run and do, I'll probably level my abilities at that time. If I am there, if not, and I go to NG Plus naturally. I don't know when the DLC will be played. Well, to be honest, the DLC can be played maybe a couple of years from now, a week from now, a day, depends how long I want to dedicate, how much more time I'm dedicating to the game to get to the place where the DLCs are. But there are other games I want to play as well. I would long to try a DLC, I'm not gonna lie. I've just realised my channel's taking a very Resident Evil Souls turn. That all the things on my channel are Souls-like games or Resi. And I'm not complaining, they're both from me. One's an amazing genre, one's an amazing franchise. Despite all the backlash it gets. But I think Dark Souls 2 might be my next one in the lines, unless something else pops up. I want to play Dark Souls 2. Because mind you, the Dark Souls 2 camp, or I guess Dark Souls 2 story was alright, the world was alright. The PvP was atrocious. Actually, no. Hang on, let me think. No, the opposite way around. I didn't like the story, but I loved the PvP in Dark Souls 2. Yeah, I loved the PvP in Dark Souls 2, but I hated the story. It was Dark Souls 1 I loved the story, but hated the PvP. And then Dark Souls 3 didn't really nail anything for me. It was just kind of mediocre on both. Anyway, Hades, code owner, Gregorio Silva. Wait, hang on. Boasts high attack power based in strength and dexterity. Ideal for using heavy gear. You acquired a new blood code. Let's have a look. Achievement locked to eternity. Save complete. You can now play using your post-completion save data. You can start the game again from just before the end by selecting your completed save data from the load option of the title screen. After starting the game again, you can examine the door back at base to carry over your save data and restart the story from the beginning. You can examine the door back at base to carry over your save data. What door? Code Vein. Okay, Code Vein. Done. As I said during the credits, I recommend it. Buy it. Buy it. Play it. See what you think for yourselves. Also, let me know what builds you guys want to use or like for using. I think I might actually go look some builds up now. Well, not right now, but... you know, while I'm playing for it, I might look at some builds. I know there is a build to do with the Impaler. I did see that. Not sure if I've used it yet, but I need to have a look. So I will admit, I did look up the depths. Many girls are going to do it on the video, and I wanted to know where the last depth stuff was, because I didn't want to miss anything. I didn't want to lose out on the stuff in the depths, especially like the scout stuff, because of NG+. I didn't want to. But turns out I don't need to worry about it anyway, because it's key letting us stay in the safe. Should we have a quick look? It's going to be a longer video, but... continue. Load. Oh yeah. I forgot I had these. That was the original playthrough on the channel. That was a test. That one broke. I can't remember what happened, but something happened to that one. I probably mentioned it right at the start of this series. That was my test one to see why it broke and what I did. I believe, at least. Yeah, July 3rd. Yeah, it was. That was like I made that one to see what was wrong with that one and see if I can replicate it. I couldn't, I don't think, so I gave up. And then this is this one. So we have a look. I want to find that door. I don't want to go for the door, but I want to find it. Because if I can just go to the DLC now in this playthrough, it might happen sooner than expected. Oh no, why is he there? I did say before the boss, so maybe that's nothing. Maybe I don't need to worry about that. Home base. Have a look at home base. So warm in this room. I do need to record mode or Code Vein as well. Well, I think I might take a short break from Code Vein. I might play something else in the meantime, then come back for the DLC. I think I need to mix some stuff up a bit more. Just to keep myself a bit more interested. I'm loading. Because it is getting a bit stale now for me. Not the games themselves, it's just the repetition of doing the same thing. I need to play something else. I need something else. Who are you? Oh, I know. I know who you are. Oh, shinies. Tower of Trials. Is that more depth stuff? Well, I might do that on the channel then. That could be do that. But I could do the Tower of Trials and the, DLC, that's the one. Where's the door? Oh, that one. Now, if I hover over it, will it say, like, start new game, or... play the story again? Ah. Now it'll take me to NG+. Right. Okay, I'm with so far. But... that's all I've got time for this session, really. I... did a lot. I might do some more leveling. Well, not leveling. Ability leveling in my own time. And, yeah. Hope you all enjoyed. If you did, have a like button, also subscribe. And also share the video around. It all helps me out a lot. And it's very much appreciated. And I highly recommend this game. It's a good game. Get it. Play it. Enjoy it. Share with me your builds. If you have already played it and you've already got that, share with me your builds anyway. I want to know. What do you guys use? Because it might be worth me looking at it and going, oh, I could use that for this code, you know. Because let's face it, my Impaler's not going to work with every code. It would be nice to have weapons that do work with every code. But no, we do not. No, we do not. No more copyrighted music. Anyway, as I said before, I hope you all enjoyed, and cheers for watching. I'll see you all in the next series. whatever I make next. Or be one of the current video series, or carry one of the series I've got going. And any other one you want to tune into. But Code Vein will be on a short break for the time being. It will come back soon. Or I find a small game to play alongside the four, or as a fourth series, but I don't think I'm gonna do. I think I might replace Code Vein with something else and come back and do a DLC later after that. But if that's the case, it won't be Dark Souls 2, I'll find something shorter to play. But until then, see you all next time. Cheers for watching. I'm gonna go get a drink and relax, because it's too warm in here. Way too warm. Don't.